Dear students, welcome to the English class. Today we are going to deal with preposition. What is a preposition? A preposition is a word or phrase that describes the relationship between noun and other words in a sentence. A preposition is a word or phrase that describes the relationship between noun and other words in a sentence. It links nouns, pronouns, and phrases to other words in a sentence. It links nouns, pronouns, and phrases to other words in a sentence. Look at these examples. Here,
it is a
letter for you. This book is on the table. They met before lunch. In these three sentences, look at these words, for, on, before. These three words are preposition. You can identify the preposition because it links the nouns and other words in a sentence. There are four kinds of prepositions. First one is simple preposition, second one compound preposition, third one phrase preposition, and fourth one participle preposition. Simple preposition, compound preposition, phrase preposition, and participle preposition. What is simple preposition? We are going to see these kinds of preposition in detail. First one is simple preposition. That is, prepositions at its basic form. For example, at, by, for, from, in, of, another of. Here the spelling differs. O double F. On, to, with, up. These are the prepositions at its basic form, that is, simple words. Next one is compound preposition. What is compound preposition? It is generally formed by prefixing a preposition to a noun, an adjective, or an adverb. Compound preposition is generally formed by prefixing a preposition to a noun, an adjective, or an adverb. Example: about, above, behind, below, within, without, inside, outside, between, beneath, amongst. Third one is phrase preposition. What is phrase preposition? It is a group of words used with the force of a single preposition. Group of words used with the force of a single preposition. Example: according to, by means of, in order to, with regard to, for the sake of, because of, away from. And the fourth type is participle preposition. What are participle preposition? Present participles of verbs used absolutely without any noun or pronoun being attached to them. Present participles of verbs used absolutely without any noun or pronoun being attached to them. Example: concerning, considering, touching, respecting, regarding, pending. How the relations are expressed with preposition? They are with place, time, agency or instrumentality, manner, cause or reason and purpose, possession, measure, standard, rate or value, contrast, concession, inference, motive, source, and origin. Let us see one by one in detail. First, let us see with place. See the examples. Went about the world. First one is went about the world. Which is the preposition here? About. It denotes place. Second one is in the sky. Here in is the preposition. It also denotes place. Third one is lay under the table. Here the preposition links the noun with the other words. So under is the preposition. Without preposition, no sentence will be completed. Fourth one is fell among thieves. Here which is the preposition? Among. Next sentence, stood before the door. Stood before the door. Here before is the preposition. And the next one is within the house. Which is the preposition here? Within. These are the prepositions which denotes place. Next one, time. Let us see the prepositions with time. First one is after his death. Here after is the preposition. It doesn't denote place. It denotes time. Second one, wait till tomorrow. Here till is the preposition. Third one is for many years. Here for is the preposition. Fourth one, by 3 o'clock. Here by is the preposition. Next one, towards evening. Here towards is the preposition. Students, you can understand the prepositions while reading the sentence itself. Next, we are going to see the examples for agency and instrumentality. First one is sell goods at auction. Second one is destroyed by fire. Third one, cut it with the knife. Fourth one, send the parcel by post. Here, I think you can identify the preposition. Now you can identify the preposition. And here comes manner. Examples for manner. First one is dying by inches. Second one, fought with courage. Third one, won with ease. Here, by, with, and in the third example also, with. These are the prepositions. Without preposition, if you look at the sentence, it won't give the meaning. Only preposition decides the meaning. Next one, we are going to see the examples for cause, reason, and purpose. First example is died from fatigue. She was with fever. Labored for good of humanity. Did it for our good. Here, what are the prepositions? From, with, for. Next comes the examples for possession. The mask of Omar. A man of means. Third one, the boy with red hair. Here, of and with are the prepositions. Then we are going to see the examples for measure, standard, rate and value. First one, I am taller than you by 2 inches. I am taller than you by 2 inches. Second one, he charges interest at 9%. At, here at is the preposition. Then cloth is sold by the yard. Here by is the preposition. Then comes examples for contrast and concession. First example is, for one enemy, he has 100 friends. Here, for is the answer. Second one, with all his faults, I admire him. Here, with is the preposition. And in the third sentence, after every effort, one may fail. Here, after is the preposition. See, one word
occurs in
different places. You have to understand which word or which preposition comes to which place without changing the meaning. Then comes examples for inference, motive, source and origin. First example is, from what I know of him, I hesitate to trust him. Here, from is the preposition. From, to, by, on, foot, these prepositions are well known to you. Second one is, his skill comes from practice. Third one, light emanates from the sun. Third one, opposite. Opposite is the preposition. First one is, Ram is sitting opposite Shyam. Second one, his house is opposite to ours. So, opposite is also a preposition. Then comes in front of. You may familiar with this word, in front of. This is called phrase preposition. He parked the car in front of the hotel. Second example, he put the plates on the table in front of us. Over. This is also a famous preposition you all know. It is used to talk about a movement from one side of a place to another, such as surfaces or lines. Over is the preposition, and it is used to talk about a movement from one side of a place to another, such as surfaces or lines. For example, I shall jump over the wall and open the gate. The aircraft flew over the lake. Here you can very well understand the preposition. Then across. Across is the preposition, and it is used to express position in relation to something which stretches from one side of a place to another. And it is used to express position in relation to something which stretches from one side of a place to another. Examples: there was a barrier across the road. The bank is across the street. Then another famous preposition, along. It is used to show the movement and following a line. It is used to show the movement following a line. First example is, he walked along the line. Second one, they were walking along the road. Well-wishers began placing flowers along the railings. Somewhere along the path, there is a signpost. Then comes the famous preposition to, and the easiest preposition to. It indicates movement with the aim of a specific destination, which can be a place or an event. It indicates movement with the aim of a specific destination, which can be a place or an event. For example, I am going to USA tomorrow. Are you going to the party? What time did you go to work? Can you tell me the way to the station? You never commit any mistake in this preposition to. Next, up to. It is often used to express movement to a person. For example, she came up to me and asked me what the time was. Next preposition is towards. It indicates movement in a particular direction. It indicates movement in a particular direction. Examples: she was carrying a suitcase and walking towards the railway station. He hit the ball towards the goal. At. Here, in this preposition, many of you have committed mistakes. If you understand clearly, you need not commit or you cannot commit any mistake in this preposition at. At is used for a precise time. When will you use at? It is used for a precise time. For examples, at 3 o'clock, at 9 a.m., at sunrise, at night, at the moment, at present, at the same time. Have you all understood clearly? Here you will have the confusion at versus in. For this dash, at will come or in will come, you will have the same confusion. So you need not confuse anything, you understand clearly. At is used for a small place, but in is used for a big place. Have it in your mind. At is used for a small place and in is used for a big place. For example, he lives at Alwar in Rajasthan. Rajasthan is a district, it is a big place, so we are using in here. And Alwar is a particular place, that too a small place, so we are using at here. Now are you clear? The second example, a temple is situated at Madurai in Tamil Nadu. Here you can understand very clearly, Tamil Nadu is a big place and it is a state, and Madurai is a small place within the state. So for the big place we are using in, and for a small place we are using at. And one more explanation, at shows stable position and in shows movement. At shows stable position and in shows movement. What is stable position? Without movement. Okay, for example, she is at home. She is at home means she doesn't go anywhere. Second example, the taxi is in motion. Motion means movement. So the taxi is moving. So we are using in there. Now, few more examples for in. In is used for enclosed space. For examples, in the garden, in Delhi, in India, in a car, in my wallet, in a box. And in is used for long periods, centuries, years and months. So you need not confuse anything, understand it clearly. Few more examples for these things. In 1990, in the next century, in the ice age, in the past, in the morning, in the mornings. You should understand the difference between morning and mornings. Morning means a particular morning. Mornings means a few mornings. Then, in is used for existing state of things. In is also used for existing state of things. For examples, he is swimming in the river. There are 25 students in the class. Next comes the preposition on. On is used for days and dates. You need not panic about on because it is used for days and dates. On Sunday, on Tuesdays, on 6th March, on Independence Day, on my birthday, on Monday evening. And on is used for a surface. For examples, on the ceiling, on the page, on the carpet, on the door, on the floor. Few more examples and few more exercises for you by using prepositions. You have to fill up the blanks. Take down the questions. and if you look at the pictures only, you can answer these questions. You see the picture. You take down the questions and answer. First question is, the lion is dash the rhino and the buffalo. Can you identify the lion? Where is the lion? The lion is dash the rhino and the buffalo. The options are next to, behind, between. You see the picture carefully and look at the place where lion is there. So you can easily fill up the blanks with the preposition. You should understand the meaning for each and every preposition. Then you can easily fill up the preposition and you will never commit any mistakes in preposition. Preposition comes for your 1 mark. Second question is, see the picture. Santa is dash a big yellow star. Santa is dash a big yellow star. Options are behind, on, in front of. Can you identify the Santa there? Yes. Third question. See the picture also side by side. The snake is dash the grass and the ladybird is dash the mushroom. The snake is dash the grass and the ladybird is dash the mushroom. Options are on and under. Second one, under and on. And the third one, in and in. Choose the correct answer. Then the fourth question is, Judy is dash the school psychologist. She is taking dash her. Judy is dash the school psychologist. She is taking dash her. Options are first one, next to and to. Second one, in front of and with. Third one, opposite and to. There are two words given. First one is for the first dash and the second one is for the second blank. Side by side, you watch the picture and you can find out the answer easily. Then come to the fifth question. There are a lot of sweets dash the jar. There are a lot of sweets dash the jar. Which one to choose? Option A, in, on, by. Then come to the sixth question. The three children are dash the books. The three children are dash the books. Option A, in front of, B, under, C, behind. Seventh question. Where is the alien? It is dash the UFO. Where is the alien? It is dash the UFO. Options are at, in, on. Eighth question. Janet is dash the grasshopper. She is looking dash it. Janet is dash the grasshopper. She is looking dash it. A, opposite and on. B, opposite and to. C, opposite and at. Then ninth question. Carol is carrying our breakfast dash her tray. Carol is carrying our breakfast dash her tray. On, under, in. Tenth question. Are you all following? Take down the tenth question. Look, Jonas is dash the mouth of the whale. Look, Jonas is dash the mouth of the whale. At, in, next to. 11th question. They are having a birthday party - June 21st. They are having a birthday party - June 21st. The options are in, at, on. The last question in this picture. There are some colorful eggs - the chick. There are some colorful eggs - the chick. The options are next to, in front of, behind. Have you all noted down? It is very easy to write now. Then another exercise for you. Here also, you should watch the picture clearly and you can answer the questions. A picture is given, three options are given. You have to choose the right one. Are you ready? Yes. Put tick mark on the circle beside the sentence with the correct preposition. See, a jam bottle is there. You have to tick the correct sentence. What are the sentences? Option A, jam is in the bottle. Second one, jam is on the bottle. And the third option, jam is under the bottle. You can easily find out the answer. Am I right? If you look at the picture and answer means, you will be very eager to answer. And the preposition will be very easy to you. Second question is, what can you see in the picture? A pen is there. Okay. A pen is under a pillow. Option B, a pen is on a pillow. Option C, a pen is in a pillow. You can easily find out the answer. Shall we go to the third one? What are you seeing there? There's a TV. Option A, a TV is in the wall. Option B, a TV is on the wall. Option C, a TV is under the wall. Next question. What are you seeing there? A man is sitting. Okay. Option A, a man is on the rug. Option B, a man is under the rug. Option C, a man is in the rug. Shall we go to the next question? Yes. What can you see there? It's a cake. Cake and oven is there. You have to connect the two things. Option A, a cake is in the oven. Option B, a cake is on the oven. Option C, a cake is under the oven. And just two more exercises for you related with pictures. Okay. It will be interesting to you to complete. Choose the correct preposition to complete the sentence. Look at the picture. A file is - the cabinet. Options are in, on, under. If you don't look at the picture, you cannot answer it correctly. So, watch the picture carefully and answer. Second one is, a rat is - the hat. A rat is - the hat. In, on, under. Third question is, a rabbit is - a burrow. A rabbit is - a burrow. In, on, under. Fourth one is, children are playing - the park. Children are playing - the park. In, on, under. Fifth question, a kitten is - a box. A kitten is - a box. In, on, under. The last one in this picture is, a bug is - a rug. A bug is - a rug. In, on, under. See, these six questions have the options in, on, under. The same options all the six questions have. You have to choose the correct one. You have clearly understood these three prepositions in, on, under, and also other prepositions. If you need any clarifications, you can ask me in the class. Thank you. Have a nice day.
இந்நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி: சிறப்பு அலுவலர், கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி, 8ஆம் தளம், அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம், காந்தி மண்டப சாலை, கோட்டூர்புரம், சென்னை 685. தொலைபேசி எண் 7824040. 1500.